It'll be months, if not years, before a woman in Burien who was attacked by a pit bull in July recovers from her disfiguring injury. So you can imagine her dismay at learning the owner of the dog is fighting the city to bring it back home. James Lynch is here with the story. James, that dog actually ripped off part of her face.
Really did, David. It's probably some of the worst injuries that I've ever seen in a pit bull attack. And surprising to a lot of people, the Burien Animal Control returned the dog to its owners. They simply banned it from the city limits. Now the owners are appealing even that in a hearing scheduled for tomorrow morning. A word of warning here, the woman's injuries are difficult to see.
By all accounts, Jeanette Cunningham was an attractive, vibrant woman before she was mauled by a pit bull named Kiko. Now her face looks like this.
She's probably going to need at least three, possibly four future reconstruction surgeries.
Chris Davis is her attorney. He describes the attack that happened in July when Cunningham was walking here along Southwest 143rd Street and the dog got out of this yard.
If you can imagine a dog comes out of nowhere and jumps up on you and attacks you and essentially rips off and chews up your lower lip.
We do know that Kiko attacked her. We do not know exactly the situation that led up to that, but it appears to be what's considered by the law an unprovoked attack.
Dr. Leslie Casper is director of Burien Animal Care and Control. She says the dog was quarantined for 10 days and held until after their investigation found it should be banned from the city. Putting a dog down is not an option in Burien if it can be relocated. Besides, Dr. Casper says in spite of the injuries Kiko caused, she didn't feel he posed a significant risk to the community.
I believe this dog has some behavioral issues that needed to be worked out. Was it a vicious dog who was going to attack everybody? I don't believe so at all.
When a lot of people think pit bull, they think dangerous dog. Christine Hibbert is a dog behavioral expert. She says not true. Aggression is not necessarily about breed, but about how each dog is raised.
Criminals have bred pit bulls to be dog aggressive so they could fight them. But we work with beautiful pit bulls every day. That couldn't be more safe or more tolerant around children and or other dogs.
So now tomorrow, Kiko's owners will ask a judge to reverse Burien's decision to ban the dog and let Kiko come home. Dr. Casper and the victim's attorney say they doubt very seriously that will happen, and Kiko will likely remain in eastern Washington where relatives are keeping him. As for the victim, she's filed a lawsuit, David, against the Kiko's owner seeking an unspecified amount of cash. She says she'll be at the hearing tomorrow. We expect to hear from her and see her for the first time since the attack.
You know, this brings up the whole debate about pit bulls and whether they're safe or whether it's the owner that actually makes the dogs dangerous. A lot of cases we think of when a dog does something like this, they immediately put it down. Not the case, obviously, here.
Not the case in Burien. They say basically that when they have a problem like this with a dog, they can only let that dog be removed from the city if the family who owns the dog has the option of moving the dog somewhere mm-hmm. else.
And you said we'll hear from her tomorrow then.
We should, yes.
All right, James, thanks very much. Several cities in our area, including Seattle, have specific dangerous dog ordinances that put restrictions and requirements on the owner if a dog attacks someone. The strongest ones include the one in Auburn, where the city lists 12 dog breeds, including pit bulls, as potentially dangerous and requires owners to register them with the city. The city of Yakima actually passed an ordinance banning pit bull terriers, one of the few breed-specific bans in our state. And we were tipped off about this dangerous dog hearing by a viewer. Now we want to hear from you. If you have a story for us, go to Q13Fox.com and click on the news tip button on the top of our homepage.